Hi, this is Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com. From time to time, we get products from inventors, manufacturers, businesses that have products that they think might work well in our garden, and they ask if we would give our opinion on them. Yesterday in the mail, we received one such product. It's called the Root Assassin Shovel. It is a shovel, a very narrow gauge shovel made of 14 gauge metal. It has 20 serrated teeth on both sides that are sharpened on both sides. It cuts going down, cuts coming up. It's used for not only digging but also cutting roots, digging ditches. One of the suggested uses is as a whacker, going like this. Probably we wouldn't use it as a whacker, only because we like to use our clippers to trim off branches so that they are, one, more sightly, but secondly, more healthful. So that's probably not what we would use it for, but we're going to try it as a shovel today.
Well, if you had to go through a thicket of stuff, I mean, that would come in very handy as a survival kind of a tool to get through a thicket.
It weighs 4 pounds. It's ergonomically handy because of this nice grip on it. So we look for durability, ergonomic structures, value. Is it worth the price? And is it going to do the job that we want it to do?
Well, plus we want to know if tools are actually going to hold up under actual use. And again, is it a good price for the value that you're getting?
That's right.
But more importantly, does it actually work?
Does it work? Right.
So.
And I have my helper here today. Not that I wouldn't need it, because I'm sure it'll work just fine. But he's volunteered. So our son Sky is going to dig up. This is a tree we put in this spring. We gave it all summer to grow, and obviously it's not going to grow, so we will have to return it to the nursery we got it from. So we want to dig up this tree without disturbing the petunias around it. I want to have my petunias for the rest of the season.
And you think you're going to be able to do that without? Oh, that was one of the things I did like about this tool. You know, unlike most shovels, you know, that are so wide,
right,
that, you know, you really could get into some very nice areas. Now, the only thing this reminded me a little bit of, go ahead, stick her down in. That goes in pretty easily.
Okay.
Cutting the roots, not disturbing my petunias.
Oops. I can hear it cutting as it's going down.
Yeah. You go down pretty easily.
Mm-hmm.
Use your foot once and take it down all the way once. See, well, you don't even have to do that. Wow, that is nice and sharp.
One more. Okay.
Yep. Right up.
Look at that.
Look at that. Cut them all off. Obviously, not living. And look. My flowers are all still in place. I'll push in the soil a little bit and they'll be good to go for the rest of the season.
Well, I want to see it. Remember yesterday when you were pulling out weeds so we could take some samples to the class?
Yes.
I remember you had your big garden knife out.
I did.
And you were struggling to get that one
thistle. It was a Canadian thistle.
A Canadian thistle.
Yep.
So
I have a good job for it.
Okay, well, let's go test that out. Now, we've got one more tree that has to come up as well, right?
Let's see if that goes as fast as the first one.
Okay. So does it feel nice and sturdy?
Yeah.
Go down fairly easily, and I mean, I can even hear it cutting from here.
Right.
And that's nice because you can pull it back up and forth, you know, back up and down, up and down.
And it's cutting both ways.
Yeah. But again, I like the fact that you can be very precise in terms of, you know, small area that you're...
Right.
I would think this would be great for, like, if you had sod and you needed to cut into it.
Yep.
That would do a really nice job of separating the sod.
Pretty
yeah.
Good.
Look at that.
Very good. Okay.
Huh.
Let's go to my big test.
Okay.
Yesterday I was trying to dig out some weeds with my knife, which I've been very, very happy with. But they just were too stubborn and the roots were too deep. If I would have had my root assessment yesterday, I could have gotten them without a problem. So let me hand that off. I'm going to take out a burdock. Burdocks are one of those plants, those weeds that are nasty, and if you don't get them, they just keep on going.
Long roots.
Long roots. I can hear it cutting.
Well, plus you have several trees nearby too. You may be going through some of those roots, but that's okay.
I am.
On this one, I want you to put some leverage on it backwards to see how well it pulls out the soil, you know. Yeah. I like the length of it.
Yes. As you can see, this burdock is way down there. You're going to get the actual root of it so it doesn't come up again. Let's see. Not quite. See all the wood I'm cutting through.
Well, that is really down there. My goodness.
Plus, there's
you're against a larger tree root. Look at that.
That's why you have to use the root assassin on burdock.
There you go. Well, I got a tree here for you. Let's try this little puppy.
Not a puppy, it's a tree.
Yeah, well, you know, a little puppy tree.
This is a time of year when the soil is not soft and pliable because it's been dry and it's end of the year and the weeds have their roots established. I'm working on it.
Can you pull it out?
These also are known for their long tap roots.
Yep.
There you go.
Look at that one. Well, let's see what else we can pull out.
There's one more.
Okay.
Now this is an occasion when the whacking part of this tool would come in handy. This is a maple tree that we cut down, probably 5 years ago. It keeps sprouting up from the bottom and they're very hard to get totally off. But I think the whacker is going to do it.
Look at that. Two strikes. And wacky.
Excellent.
Whack away. Well, so that was cool.
I guess I would consider it a good tool for whacking.
So you are going to whack.
I am.
Okay. Well, I know of another tree that, at least two of them, that also need whacking.
I think it's more fun whacking.
There you go.
Yesterday when I was trying to use my knife, it was on a Canadian thistle. This is a small one compared to how they can get, but again, they have a long tap root, so you need to get down deep.
And we don't want to hit the water line.
Something.
which I think is about 4 feet deep anyhow, but you never know. Check digger's hotline before you dig.
Yes.
Or it could be an expensive repair.
Well, we have a lot of mulch, so over the years, different layers of mulch are in there decomposing.
And you can tell how deep that root is.
Yes.
I like the sound is really cool because you really feel and hear, you know, the sawing and the cutting.
Again, long roots. Hard to get to them when their maximum is down below where...
Well, plus all the others that you're probably not getting.
Right. So, good job.
Well, I know your little knife didn't do it yesterday.
No. Nope, well, I couldn't get deep enough.
Right.
So, Root Assassin did it.
There you go. Off to another one.
Well, that was easy. Very easy. Fun, too.
Root Assassin.
Well, you've got a lot of things in here that eventually are going to be... Using the root assassin. Assassinated.
Yeah, go ahead.
I can?
Sure.
Sure, go ahead and whack them. Look at that. Going through the jungle. Yeah, but now you gotta dig all the stumps out. Good way to take out your frustrations, too.
Yeah.
Cool. Can you chop that one in half without hitting the road, though? Yep. You know, if you needed some quick firewood and you were walking out into the woods, that would be a very handy tool to have.
Yes, it would. I think we like it. We planted this hibiscus bush two seasons ago. It just got totally decimated last winter because it was such a terrible winter. So this bush needs to come out, and then the big test will be this sunflower. We grow lots and lots of sunflowers. They're very difficult to get out of the ground. They're very sturdy plants, and it might be good to try whacking it first, Sky.
Well, I'd like to see part of this just sawed.
Oh, just sawed. Use it as a saw.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, let's get this out of the way first, so we have room to work. Oh, well, maybe not.
Whoa.
That was easy. Okay. Now, you want to saw here?
Just go ahead and saw it.
Use it as a saw and see. All steady.
Roll it.
Yep.
There you go.
Look at that.
You know, one of the things I noticed over the years when you're trying to remove these stalks.
Yes.
You know, we can sometimes get them to ground level, but getting those roots out.
Right.
Are quite troublesome.
Yeah, this
now this looks a little
easy.
Nice and loose soil here.
Loose soil, but try whacking it first, guy, if you want to give it a whack.
Well, I would say that whacks it pretty nicely.
If you had frustrations, that would help get rid of them.
Mm-hmm. Look at that.
Excellent. Nice leverage.
Comes right out.
Yep. Well, I'd say it's a very nice tool.
Yep.
It's sturdy, but it's not too heavy. It seems like it does a multiple of jobs.
Well built. Now, price-wise, I think it ran about just under $60, if I'm not mistaken.
Yes. And I think it'll last for years and years.
Yeah, well, that's an important thing whenever you're investing in tools.
Definitely.
It felt very solid when I picked it up and used it. And
it has guards that go on the edges, so if you're putting it with your other tools, you won't have to worry about them getting
And they're not that
up.
Sharp where you would...
Oh, no.
I mean, you obviously, if you put a lot of pressure on, you might cut yourself, but it's fairly safe to run your hands across. I was running my hands across it.
Okay, I can do that.
There's a little split in there. Yep.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Helpful assistant. There we go. Well, if you're interested in finding out more about this tool, check out our website at wisconsingarden.com, and we'll have a link for you to check it out.
And again, it's the Root Assassin Shovel.
Mm-hmm.
Cool. I want to thank Todd for contacting us and, asking if we'd be interested in sharing, testing the tool and possibly sharing it with all of our viewers. So we're going to do that. Thank you, Todd. Thumbs up. I think you got a real winner here.
I would recommend it for your garden toolbox.
Yeah.
Nice tool.
Very good.
Bye for now. If you enjoyed this demonstration, please give us a thumbs up. Love to hear your comments. If you've had one, tell us how it works. And love to have you join our garden family by subscribing also. Bye for now.
So what are you going to chop up next? I saw you have a wood pile over there.
Yes, I do.
Just don't whack me while I'm sleeping.
No, dear.
Thank you.